Tech giant Amazon has just launched 27 internet satellites into low Earth orbit. The aim? To compete with Elon Musk's Starlink and offer satellite internet to millions. Project Kuiper is expected to be available later this year. So, how does it work and what's in it for you? About one-third of the world's population doesn't have internet access. Many of them live in rural or remote areas. The main reason? It's not profitable for internet providers to build the infrastructure to connect these areas. In short, not profitable, no internet. Satellite internet could change that. It has the potential to cover every corner of the planet, no matter how remote. Right now, Elon Musk's Starlink is the main player in this field. The company has launched over 7,000 satellites and offers internet in nearly 120 countries. But there are downsides. In the US, Starlink costs about $120 a month. That's about 105 euros, much more than most fiber plans. And before you even get started, you need special hardware. The Starlink dish costs around $349. So yeah, it's powerful, but pricey. Now with Amazon entering the game, that could change. More competition often means lower prices and better service. But how does satellite internet actually work? Let's break it down. In a nutshell, your device connects to a small private transmission station. From there, your search request, for example, is sent to the nearest available satellite in a network of thousands orbiting the Earth. The satellites are flying more than 500 kilometers above us, and they use optical lasers to pass on your request. Once the signal is close enough to a ground station, it is sent back to Earth, where your question is processed, and sent back to you the same way. Sounds complicated? That's because it is. You need thousands of satellites, all moving at nearly 30,000 kilometers per hour, and they have to stay in sync, constantly connecting with your dish and the ground infrastructure. Still, it works. Starlink already offers speeds of up to 220 megabits per second. Amazon hasn't launched a service yet, but it claims Project Kuiper will deliver up to 400 megabits per second with the standard package. Impressive, right? Well, there are some drawbacks. In theory, Starlink and Kuiper offer low latency. That means they can be fast enough for things like real-time gaming. But in practice, a few things can slow it down. Bad weather, for example, or just too many users on the network. That's not ideal if you rely on a stable high-speed connection. To deal with demand, companies need to launch more satellites. SpaceX plans to send up 5,000 more soon, aiming for 12,000 total, and possibly expanding to over 34,000 in the future. Project Kuiper plans to deploy over 3,000 satellites in the coming months. Some scientists are sounding the alarm. The more satellites there are in orbit, the higher the risk of a collision, they argue. One broken satellite can create space debris, and that debris can trigger chain reactions, making space a more dangerous place for everyone. Project Kuiper is set to orbit slightly higher than Starlink, between 590 and 630 kilometers, compared to Starlink's 550 kilometers. Still, experts say this growing number of satellites could interfere with other systems and make space travel and communication much harder. Is satellite internet an option for you? Let us know.